2B2T history is about to be made. An accomplishment that has never been done before. Trapping more than 50 players in the same place at the same time. If pulled off successfully, it's going to be the largest player gathering in the server's history. You have to remember that on the oldest Anarchy server in Minecraft, the majority of players online at any given time are usually scattered hundreds of thousands of blocks apart, sometimes millions. So for this many people to come together in one place is going to be insanity. Now, you're probably wondering, how are we going to get that many people together without having them try and kill each other? Well, the answer is they won't be able to kill each other, because they'll be trapped in the Obsidian Labyrinth, an inescapable maze that will keep players together long enough for the record to be set. This is potentially one of the most elaborate death traps ever set up in the server's history. From the outside, it might seem like a simple obsidian box covered in water, but once you go inside, you start to realize how many hours of work actually went into this. Today, we're going to be discussing what this thing actually is, how it was made, how we're going to lure 50 people here all at once, and hopefully, you'll get to see the record be set and chaos unfold. I've never made a 2B2T video like this before, so let's get started. Here's the plan. Several groups will have to work together in order to get enough unsuspecting players into the maze. The Guardsmen, the Infinity Incursion, and the Fight Club will all be playing a crucial role in this. The Guardsmen were responsible for the labyrinth itself, with 2B2T player Orsund being the mastermind behind it. It took 7 weeks to build from start to finish, and it's the result of multiple players working together in less than ideal conditions. Orsund wanted to make a sprawling puzzle that would be almost impossible to escape and cause frustration to even experienced players. The labyrinth is a giant obsidian maze that has no exits. How it works is players will enter it via portal from the Nether. Once trapped inside, they will have to try and find their way out, except as I mentioned, there is no way out, so they'll be stuck navigating the maze. To make sure the obsidian is not mined, 5 Elder Guardians will be brought in from local ocean monuments to give everyone mining fatigue, preventing them from breaking the obsidian blocks. While a bucket of milk can easily get rid of mining fatigue, this item is rarely carried by 2B2T players, so it should be a while before any of them are able to escape. Chorus Fruit will not work, as they will only teleport you to a different hallway inside the maze. You can't get out of it. Plus, using too many Chorus Fruit in a row on the server will get you disconnected. On top of the labyrinth, a giant water cube will surround it to prevent griefing from the outside. With no exits, small hallways, Elder Guardians, and a water cube, players should be trapped long enough for the record to be set. Many of us will be watching this take place from the outside, so in order to deal with the mining fatigue from the Guardians, Orsund, Gomer, and a few others have airlifted a cow 6,000 blocks and brought it to the labyrinth using flying machines. So that's how the labyrinth works. Now, the issue is, how do we get enough people out here at once? This is where Fight Club and the Infinity Incursion come into play. How it's going to work is, Ken, the leader of Fight Club, is going to post coordinates to the Nether portal on a Friday night. Fight Club is one of the biggest social events on the server these days, so that will ensure we have plenty of people coming to the event. They think this will be the location of Fight Club, so once they pass through the portal, they'll be stuck. The Infinity Incursion is sending guards to ensure that anyone that tries to disrupt the event is killed or at least stalled, as well as convince even more people to come to the maze. The Fight Club and the Infinity Incursion actually hold the current record of most people in a single place on the server, but that was at spawn, and the labyrinth is located in the Guardsman homeland, which is a few thousand blocks away in the Nether. All of these groups will have to come together perfectly in order for this to work. Hopefully, they'll be trapped long enough for the record to be set. We need to surpass 50 people in order to take the record. I think it's doable, but the maze itself is actually quite complex, it'll definitely keep people occupied. Anyway, I'm here at the Labyrinth 24 hours before the event is set to take place. For me to be here on my main account would be suicide and could potentially ruin the event. So I'll be quietly filming everything on an alt account. The guardsmen have worked incredibly hard building this. Hopefully everything goes smoothly and there aren't any hiccups. I really hope there are no hiccups. 6 hours left and we've got a little bit of a problem right now. Last night some idiot came by and killed the Elder Guardians for no reason, so now they're hard at work transporting more Guardians to the maze in time. I think we should be able to get them in place before the event starts, but fingers crossed. That was a close one. We've got about an hour before the event, and the guardsmen managed to get the Elders back in the Labyrinth, so mission accomplished. But I'm gonna go get set up in the Nether to await everyone's arrival. I think Ken is gonna be releasing the coordinates in about 45 minutes, so we'll see how this goes tonight. A few people are here at the portal in the Nether so far, but I'm gonna wait till more people arrive before I enter the Labyrinth, because once we go in, it's gonna be pretty crazy. There we go, a ton of people have arrived now, so I think it's pretty safe for us to actually get in there ourselves. This is it, the moment of truth. Are we gonna break the record tonight? Let's see. And that is a lot of tracers. All right, this is looking promising so far. Okay, let's actually get out of the maze first and then we can assess what's going on. So far, no one's trying to kill each other yet. So this is a very promising sign. I'm on the very bottom layer of the labyrinth right now. I'm just waiting for people to get away from me. Then I'm gonna chug my milk and then hopefully dig down through the obsidian and get out. Give it the old college chug. There we go. All right, dig. And there we go. Perfect. Plug it up. Excellent, we've escaped. Now let's get to the top of the cube and see what's going on. This mining fatigue is working a lot better than I thought it would. I mean, all these players are still trapped inside. They're trying to dig, but as you can see, nothing's happening. I'm keeping track of how many names I come across. I think we're gonna break the record tonight. It's looking real promising. All five of the Elder Guardians are still safe, as long as they're still alive. That's what's gonna keep this event going. So far, I've counted 39 people at the event, and more keep coming every minute, so this is very, very promising. You know, despite this thing being a massive death trap, I'm actually shocked at how peacefully everyone's trying to navigate the maze, at least for now. And that didn't last long. Looks like Universius is in some trouble right now. Let's see if he can escape. Oh, he's got chorus fruit. Is this gonna work? Oh, look at that clean getaway. You'll love to see it. I've took a head count, 46. We need 4 more people and we've got it. And at the rate they're coming in, we should have it in a few minutes. But I just hope they can all stay alive long enough. Those stragglers better hurry up because they're dropping the withers now. Oh yeah, they've only got about, I'd say 2 minutes before everyone starts getting out. Oh man, 52 players I've counted here. I mean, they're spread across this entire thing. I can't even get them all in render distance. So now the question is, how long are the Elder Guardians going to survive for? Even the mastermind of the labyrinth is getting some PvP action in. That's pretty awesome. All 4 of the Outer Guardians have been killed, which means only the one in the middle remains. And according to my watch, it's been 32 minutes, which means that last one is living on borrowed time right now. We'll see how it fares. A bunch of players have escaped topside, so it's only gonna go downhill from here. Oh, and look at that. The chaos has already started. People trying to kill each other. Well, we did what we could. They're trying to break into the final chamber to kill the last guardian, so it looks like the event might be coming to a close really soon. Whoa! Oh! They tried to kill me as I was filming down there. Even on an alt account, I'm not safe. Could you imagine if I was on my main account right now? I would be dead by now. Now that the final guardian's been killed, it lasted 41 minutes, and we got 52 people here at the same time, a brand new record. There was 4 deaths and 1 suicide, so this labyrinth did the job of keeping everyone alive long enough for the record to be set. Wow, this was absolute chaos here, and I loved every minute of it. And if you loved every minute of it, make sure to leave a like and hit that subscribe button. Also, make sure to follow me on Twitter and Instagram to stay updated on when new content's coming out. But that's it for today, everyone. Take it easy, and if you plan to play, Stay alive out there.